Good morning, students. In today's lecture, we will see the phasor diagram of CT. In previous lecture, we have discussed the equivalent circuit of CT and its notations. This is basically the mathematical analysis of CT. We are doing this analysis to find out the errors in CT. As we already discussed that CT and basically instrument transformers have two types of error, phase error and ratio error. So these are the notations. Coming to the phasor diagram of CT, I have written some expressions here to simplify the phasor diagram of CT. We'll start from phi as a reference. Now the induced secondary voltage is 90 degree apart of working flux phi m. So first we'll make I naught, which is the resultant of phi I m and I e. So I m will be the in phase with phi, and I e is 90 degree apart of I m. So the resultant of I e and I m will be I naught, and I naught will be alpha degree away from I m, that is alpha is angle between I naught and working flux phi. So now we have to make the angle del, which is the angle between secondary current and secondary induced voltage. For that we have to make ES. So first of all we'll make Vs, that is we know that delta is the angle between Is and Vs. So we'll make Vs in parallel to Is, we'll make Is Rs, and 90 degree apart we'll make Is and Xs. The resultant of Vs, Is Rs and Is Xs will be Es. So we'll get del angle between Is and Es. If we'll make vertically opposite angle and extend this Is into Is, the angle between this line and this will be del. That is totally a vertically opposite angle. Here Nis is the secondary current in referred to the primary. So we'll get the del angle between these two lines. Now we have Ip, that is the resultant of Nis and I naught. So we have to make resultant Ip. If we extend a parallel line to I naught in this direction and a parallel line to Nis in this direction, and both the line will coincide at this point, and we'll get the Ip as a resultant. For the mathematical expression, we will have to make the 90 degree extending this Nis up to B point. So we have points 0, A, B and C. B is a 90 degree angle, and this angle is 90 minus alpha minus del. Like if these are two parallel line and this is a transversal, this angle will be equals to this angle. So if we see that this is whole 90 degree, and if we minus del and alpha, we'll get this angle. And this angle is equals to A, B and C angle. And accordingly, if we have this B angle is 90 degree, A angle is 90 minus alpha minus del, we'll get C angle is del plus alpha. So this is a phasor diagram of CT. For the phase error and ratio error, we need first of all transformation ratio of CT. that is R is equals to IP is equal IP divided by IS. We have following notation: angle BAC, that is angle A, is equals to 90 minus del minus alpha. Angle BCA is equals to del plus alpha, that is angle C, we have seen. AC, that is A and C, is equals to I naught, because we have make this vector parallel to I naught, so we have AC as I naught. OA, that is OA, is equals to NIS. OC, O and C, we have IP. AB, for AB, we have I naught sin del plus alpha. And for BC, will have I naught cos del plus alpha. From right angle formula, we have this OC is equals to OB square plus BC square. So if we divide this OB part in OA plus OB, we'll get our formula like this. OC square is equals to OA plus OB square plus BC square. We have, from above, we have OC is equals to IP, OA is equals to NIS, AB is equals to I naught sin del plus alpha bracket whole square. We have BC is equals to I naught cos del plus alpha whole square. If we open this square bracket, we'll get N square IS square I naught square sin square del plus alpha plus 2n is I naught sin del plus alpha I naught square cos del plus alpha. If we see, we'll have sin square and cos square, that tends to be 1. So we'll take I naught common from this, and sin square del plus alpha plus cos square del plus alpha tends to be 1. So finally we'll get IP square is equals to n square I square plus 2n is I naught sin del plus alpha plus I naught square. Therefore, we'll get the IP like this. For transformation ratio, RP is equals to IP upon IS. We'll get the expression like this: under root of n square I square IS square plus 2n is I naught sin del plus alpha plus I naught square divided by IS. Now we have to actually reduce this equation to square of this. So for that we need some assumptions to be made. For well designed CD, we have I naught very less than NIS. Usually I naught is less than 1% of IP. So therefore we can say that IP is equals to NIS. If we put this IP is equals to NIS in our phasor diagram, we'll get theta is equals to 0. We have written here theta, that is the angle between NIS and IP, that is to be 0. If we put this theta is equals to 0, we'll get del plus alpha is equals to 90 degree. So if we put sin del plus alpha, that tends to be 1. So in this above equation, we'll put n square is square plus 2n is I naught sin del plus alpha plus I naught square. And with this, we'll put sin square del plus alpha. This is actually 1. So we can add this here. By reducing the above expression, we'll get a square root of NIS plus I naught sin del plus alpha. So square and the square root is cancelled out. So finally we'll get R is equals to NIS plus I naught sin del plus alpha divided by IS. So the transformation ratio turns to be N plus
I naught by Is sine del plus alpha. This is the approximate equation of transformation ratio, where we can see that transformation ratio is equal to turn ratio plus I naught by Is sine del plus alpha. Here n is turn ratio. The derivation and theory is applicable when secondary burden has lagging power factor, that is when burden is inductive. If we take our transformation ratio further, we'll get n plus I naught by Is. If we'll open this sine del plus alpha, we'll get sine del cos alpha plus cos del sine alpha. From this equation, we'll get R is equals to n plus Im sine del plus Ie cos del. This expression is divided by Is. Is is not divided by turn ratio. Only this part Im sine del plus Ie cos del is divided by Is, where Im is I naught cos alpha, Ie is equals to I naught sine alpha. So this is the transformation ratio. We'll get the R ratio error from this expression. For phase angle, like we need phase angle also for deriving our phase error. The phase angle is defined as an angle by which the secondary current phasor, when reversed, differs in phase from the primary current. Like when we'll reverse the secondary current phasor, how much the difference will or like how much angle it lags or leads from our primary current. This is the phase angle. The sign of phase angle is decided as, if the secondary current when reversed leads the primary current, then the angle will be positive. And if the secondary current reversed lags our primary current, then the angle is taken to be negative. Now we are deriving the phase angle. Let angle between Is reversed and Ip is theta. Means phase angle is theta. So in triangle OBC, if we go to our phasor diagram, in triangle O, B and C, we'll have our tan theta angle. So in triangle OBC, we have tan theta is equal to BC upon OB, where BC is equal to BC, and we'll divide our OB part in OA plus AB. If we put our values in this, we'll get tan theta is equal to I naught cos del plus alpha divided by NIS plus I naught sine del plus alpha. We'll assume that theta is very small here, so the above equation reduces tan theta to theta. I naught cos del plus alpha divided by NIS plus I naught sine del plus alpha. Here I naught is very very less than NIS, so the above equation here I naught get eliminated. So theta is equals to I naught cos del plus alpha divided by NIS. If we open this part also, we'll get I naught cos del cos alpha minus sine del sine alpha. If we put again Im and Ie, we'll get theta is equals to Im cos del minus Ie sine del divided by NIS. If we convert this radian into degree, we'll multiply the above expression with 180 degree divided by pi. So we have derived two equations for transformation ratio and for phase angle. Now the ratio and phase angle error in CT are as follows. For ratio error, from the above expression we have derived R is equals to N plus Im sine del plus Ie cos del divided by Is. So our ratio error will depend on this. We can conclude from our equation that the sum of that our ratio error, our ratio, transformation ratio, is equals to the sum of turn ratio and the ratio of energy component of exciting current and secondary current, which gives our actual current ratio or transformation ratio in case of CT. And second, the ratio error is mainly due to the energy component of excitation current. So from these two lines we can conclude that basically our ratio error is dependent on this component, Im sin del plus Ie cos del by Is, because turn ratio is a common factor. The turn ratio is our constant factor. Therefore, the current ratio of CT is not constant for various condition of load and at various frequency. Therefore, our error is introduced in that. So the ratio error is defined as ratio error is equals to nominal ratio minus actual ratio divided by actual ratio. If we see in percentage, we'll get our above expression multiplied by 100. So our nominal ratio, we have defined this nominal ratio in previous lecture too. It's Kn minus R divided by R multiplied by 100. Basically, our nominal ratio is rated primary current divided by rated secondary current. It is normally equals to the turn ratio of current transformer, that is N. Our actual ratio is equal to actual primary current divided by actual secondary current. In above expression, we can see that Kn is positive and R is negative. So if Kn is greater than R, our ratio error will be positive, and if Kn is less than R, then our ratio error will be negative. The ratio error determines the amount of turn compensation to be reduced to reduce the error to minimum. For the approximate formula of the ratio error, the usual instrument burden is largely resistive with some inductance, and therefore del is positive and generally it's very small. Since sin del is equals to 0 and cos del is equals to 1, if we put these two in our transformation ratio, we'll get R is equals to N plus IE divided by IS. Here we have put sin del is equals to 0 and cos del is equals to 1. So therefore the ratio error is Kn minus R divided by R. We have put this R in our above equation. So here N and N will get cancelled out. We'll get minus of IE divided by IS whole divided by N plus IE divided by IS. So our ratio error turns to be minus of IE divided by whole divided by NIS plus IE. For phase angle error, when the current transformer is used for power measurement, in which current coil of wattmeter is supplied by secondary of CT, then it is necessary that secondary current of CT should be displaced exactly to 180 degree from primary. But in practical case, it's slightly less than 180 degree. Phase angle, we have derived that theta is equal to 180 degree divided by pi whole expression by Im cos del minus I sin del divided by NIS. For approximate formula for the phase angle, we'll put sin del is equal to 0 and cos del is equal to 1. So putting these in our above expression, we'll get theta is equal to 180 divided by pi Im plus NIS in degrees. So this is our phase angle error. So we have derived both the expression, ratio error and phase error. But in our case, if we put, it's a like a special one or additional case, if we put IP is equals to INS, like we have put this in above expression too, to get the sin del plus alpha is equals to 90 degree. We have put this expression previously for well-designed CT, IP is equals to NIS. Therefore, our ratio, transformation ratio, N is equals to IE by IS will be like this. N IE, we have put IS is equals to IP divided by IN. So we'll get N plus NIE divided by IP. So our transformation ratio will be like this, N in whole square, whole bracket, sorry, I1 plus IE divided by IP. And theta will be get 180 degree pi multiplied by IM divided by I in degrees. So we here we have derived the expression of phase angle error and ratio error. So for minimizing the ratio and phase angle error, we have already discussed in previous video lecture. In next lecture, we will see the potential transformer and its phasor diagram. For now, I am ending this lecture video. If there is any query related to today's e-lecture, please contact me in person or let me know. I'll provide this notes on our college website. Till then, continue your lectures. Stay healthy, stay safe.